So, with all this being said, why don't we actually do that and move over into the softwares? This is Camera Hub here, and this is actually the mode that I was using. So this is the text mode here, and you can see on prompter, there's a little picture-in-picture. You can actually see what I was seeing. So I was seeing basically this chat overlaid, and then I was seeing my own camera. In this case, now we're actually seeing the same scene. If I go over to display, I'm actually going to turn that off, so that way we're not getting too much of a streamception here. So there we go. This is what you would normally see on prompter. It's just a display. So now, for example, if I wanted to, I could move something like I could move YouTube up there. If I wanted to watch the latest episode of the Flashback podcast, where Chris, Brett, and I, we actually chat about the prompter release, TwitchCon, and a bunch of other great stuff, I could be watching that off on the side if I wanted to. Then there's also the text mode. So there's some text here, and I'm just going to turn up the opacity. This is what it normally looks like. So I've got a bunch of different options here for managing the text. So for example, if I want to make it a little bit larger, if that's easier to read, if it's further away, or I want to make the margins a little bit larger or smaller, I can do that. Now, margins are important because when you have a camera, you want to make and a prompter, you want to make sure that you're not scanning too much, right? Your eyes aren't going left and right. And so with this margin setting, you can actually make sure that your eyes aren't moving, they're not reading the words back and forth too much. Of course, you can also change the color if you want to, right? So if we want to have some different color on there, and then there's also the background as well. So we can change that if, that's easier to read. And then there's also opacity. Now, opacity is a pretty cool setting because with this, I can actually change this overlay from Camera Hub. I can change how much of the background through it is visible. So for example, if I wanted these notes over my actual camera feed, so that way I can see what I'm looking at, then I can just lower the opacity. Or let's say I had the YouTube video up behind there, I can just move that, and I could watch the video while seeing the notes on prompter or the chat. And then below that, you have scrolling settings. So with this text, for example, I can actually go ahead and just, hit play on that if I had a video script. I don't have a script in this case, just some notes. And then there's also a scroll speed setting, so I can do that as well. For text itself, we have something called a chapter system. So in here, I can have multiple different chapters, and Camera Hub can automatically advance between those. So for example, if I, maybe I want to talk about, in a script that I'm recording, I want to talk first about the setup, and then I want to talk about, the features of a product or something like that. Or let's say I'm presenting, I could set all of those up as different chapters, and then using either my mouse and keyboard or Stream Deck, I can actually jump between those chapters. And this is what it kind of looks like here. So we're expanding the compatibility and the features within these chapters, like rearranging chapters, deleting, all of that stuff. We're adding more features as time goes on. But for now, yeah, you've got this chapter view here. And the last bit is chat mode. So this is actually the mode where prompter, or well, Camera Hub will display the chat of the channel that you have selected right on prompter. And the way it works is I can just simply add a Twitch channel, Elgato, there we go. Yep, and I'll hit add, and it'll connect. And then now, when you guys type chat messages, if you're watching, there we go. Sir Crest says contributing in chat so that it shows up on screen. Perfect. There we go. So yeah, chat is showing up now. I can see it, whatever you guys are typing. Hi, mom, hugs, not a real live show if it doesn't have bugs. Absolutely, right? It wouldn't be live if there wasn't some sort of a technical issue. So yeah, that's how the chat mode works. And again, you have all the same options, right? If I want to make the font size a little bit bigger, or for example, if I just want to read chat, I don't want to see I don't want to see the background, I can set the opacity to 100%. I can make the margin size a little bit less. There we go. And again, what you guys are seeing in the picture-in-picture is exactly what I'm seeing. So yes, you actually see yourself live right now. And you can also enter different channels. So let's say that this is of course the Elgato account, but I could also enter my personal account on here and switch between those. And I could even add, maybe my favorite streamer if I just want to keep an eye on their chat and kind of see what's going on or see when they're live. I can do that as well. All of this is, of course, also controllable with Stream Deck. So if I wanted to, for example, switch between the different chat modes or even scroll, I can do that in Stream Deck. So for example, I've got a Stream Deck Plus set up here. And if I want to scroll between the different chapters here or just the text, I can do that. So let's say that I am recording a video script and I mess up and I need to go back. Then I can just, go back here, tap on it, and then it'll start scrolling again. And I can press on the dial to stop it, maybe adjust it again. Okay, you know what? I messed up. You know, with me is Jasmine, who will be queuing up questions. You know, if I mess that up, then I can just pause it, go back. All right, let's do another take there, right? So it makes that super easy. And of course, that then also works with Stream Deck Pedal. So you can kind of move up and down in text or in these chapters. And especially in if you're in a live scenario, you know, and you even want to move chat, you can do that as well, right? So if I go to chat here and you have some messages, you can see I can actually go up and down in chat as well. And, you know, let's say there was a message that was really long there. I think that first one, you know, something about contributing on screen, I can go back. What was that? Oh, there it is. And then I can go back to, you know, the live chat as well. So it's got some really powerful Stream Deck functionality there, and it's really incredible to set up.